Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Corsair Gaming Arena. We are here for our grand final, the deciding match, game number 3 between SCT. It is created. And they're going up against iDeaL Gigabyte. So it's Thailand versus a mix of Australia, New Zealand, Singapore with a dash of Korean. Let's go to the game. Actually, that's the wrong one. That's the draft. That's also the wrong one to hit. This is the right one to hit. Then we go. Would you believe it? We're starting off. This time, though, Space Creators have first pickup. So iDeaL are going into the position where they pick up both the Earthshaker and the Queen of Pain. They gave over Lashrak to SCT. And they still stuck to their guns. They wanted to ban out the Storm Spirit as well as the Lina. They did not want to have these two heroes in the play. But you've got Lashrak available. Lashrak picked up. They still have their SB available, if that is a desirable pickup for Space Creators. It's been their go-to hero, really. Remaining. Now, this is someone that can actually work with the Spirit Breaker. Like, Lina's one of them. I remember back in the days where we had, like, a less support a lot of the time. It's SD, and he'd be combining with Lashrak or Lina. Every time, it's like, he'd be combining with Lashrak or Lina. It was so easy to read. In this meta, now that he's actually a core, not going to happen. There goes the Klinks in the second phase. Bloodseeker going to be removed. They may actually add Huskar to the list as well. Because Music could just take the Lashrak to the safe lane. And normally, with most teams, I would say, yeah, Lashrak is going to be mid. I know I made a reference to this in the previous game as well, when Lashrak was picked up, that Lashrak is... Like, it rarely is he put in the safe lane. But just because the way that Space Creators have been playing their games, I would actually probably favor them to be 50-50 to be thinking about putting that Lashrak on the bot lane. So, don't put it past them. They put something else up against... Well, they don't even know they're going up against the Queen of Pain. She can end up anywhere, like always. And that is now a bit of a problem for them as well, as they look at their laning phase. So thinking, okay, Queen of Pain, Earthshaker, you may just think, let's just remove something like an Animage, so Lashrak feels a little bit more comfortable. The Phantom Lancer is another one that doesn't cause problems for Lashrak. Lashrak is actually quite good with dealing with the Phantom Lancer, because Pulse Nova and Edict just destroy all the illusions, so you don't lose mana that quickly. You expend mana to keep mana, as a way of putting it. So there's iDeaL want to take out the Huskar as well. Huskar with the Dazzle is just such a brutal combo. Remaining. That's the reason why Huskar came to mind. After we just saw him walking around, he had like almost 50 armor when the Weave combined with him, and Shallow Grave is just such a good ability to have with him. So it makes sense. The Shallow Grave, maybe this is the time when iDeaL to say, you know what, screw it. Like we get something like an axe. Like we get a blink in axe. I'm still waiting for the return of Slaughter. And now he's weak. But it's... I'd like to see him come back. They go with a Gyro.
Radiant team pick.
Never really can say, oh, wow, you picked Gyro. That was a bad move. So they'd run a safe lane Gyro, a potential Quap mid or bottom, and a support Earthshaker. The Lashrak is potential bot or mid. Dazzle
10 seconds
normally
remaining.
Goes with Music or wherever he goes, but can be quite flexible in this game.
5 seconds remaining.
May even think about starting in the mid lane if Queen of Pain, like if you're going to run a little bit more
Reserve
of a
time.
Riskier hero in that lane. You'd actually like to see from them. I'd actually like to see a DK. A Blink Dagger DK coming out from Space Creators. The armor advantage would be absolutely ridiculous. Gyro actually wouldn't even touch the Dragon Knight. The Queen of Pain burst damage would still cause some problems, but they're gonna go. Where's that Techies? Where's that Techies? Where is Techies? we're getting Tusk and Tusk and Tusk, but no Tech. But the Tusk are in the Dazzle, so there's our dual offlane. So in this case, the tradition is broken, where the Dazzle just follows wherever the Music goes. Instead, he should be combining up with the Tusker. They still want to find some follow-up stun. Tusker stun by itself is not enough. That's not the way Space Creators like to play the Tusker. It becomes very
radiant team pick.
It's a little too passive for them. They could go for something like a... I was just thinking, like, massive thing. If you push the Tusker into a support role, and then you get Clockwork. So you got really good initiation. The Disruptor, though, is going to cause problems with that. I just don't want to see too many heroes grouped up together. They want to try and play the range game here. You could actually get away with running, like, Tusker offlane with the Dazzle, and then run, like, Visage and Drow on the safe lane. The damage output of the Dazzle would be terrific. It'd actually win its duel up against a Disruptor. Earthshaker couldn't do jack. And the team fight control, like, Jara's, like, the Flight Cannon... I'm now double-checking my own brain for that one, but I'm fairly certain the Flight Cannon actually got reworked again so it doesn't hit the Familiars. So you don't get rid of them. You gotta do it the old-fashioned way with a direct attack. And no one is really good at doing that for iDeaL. So that's what comes to my mind at this point. It's not the greatest synergy with Lashrak, because Lashrak's not really a right-clicker. But it will give him an advantage, at least in the lane, as far as damage output goes, with both Lightning as well as his Harassment. I'm thinking more of it for the Dazzle and then just the lane presence on the bottom, and then the ability to push into towers.
10 seconds remaining.
The only distance closes you've got if you get a Blink on Earthshaker. Let's go an SK. Okay.
Dire team back.
So it's Tusker Core. They'll stick to the norm. And then push the Sand King. Farming jungle. That's the way that they can close the gaps. Really good team fight as well with Snowball into then Burrow Strike for the SK. And that's combining up with an Epicenter. Disruptor is still going to be a problem for them, but that's someone which SK is going to have to target. And we're missing one last core now from Space Creators. So the ban for iDeaL, they've got to focus on the number one position for Space Creators. They don't really cripple themselves. Actually, they may... No, they're not crippling themselves with that one because they're still looking for their mid-solo. Like, they're up against a Lashrak. They're almost certain of this now that they're going up against a Lashrak. So they could push the Queen of Pain to the offlane. She's perfectly alright up against what's there. They actually ban out the DKs. I'm thinking the same thing I was. I'm actually walking down a dangerous line where I feel like I know what I'm talking about with Dota. So I apologize to everyone. Because I'm actually picking heroes quite well today. They ban out the Templar Assassin. There might be a knee-jerk reaction from Musica. Where he's like, well, they're getting, like, they ban out the DK, like, maybe they were thinking about something like a Templar Assassin who, like, helps to deal with the DK, but could have some issues, blah, 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 blah.
Darkseer.
They get a Darkseer. Okay, so they're actually going to run the Quap in the mid, pick. The Gyro in the safe, and then the Darkseer offlane. So Space Creators need their number one position to go up against the Darkseer. Someone that can deal with the damage of the Iron Shell. And still farm up underneath the tower. There's a lot of heroes that fit into that category.
10 seconds remaining.
Most of them are still inside the pool. I don't think Music is really limited at all with this pick. Just whatever he feels going to synergize better with his team. They got elements of team fight, but they really also want to have this follow-up damage to pick. They played against this hero 3 times out of their currently played 5 games. Now they all pick it themselves. He's actually a terrific hero up against almost everything that iDeaL is running if he had space created for him. They have to keep that Darkseer off the lane. Musica will need help. It won't be as bad as what I was talking about yesterday with the Anti-Mage, because that was one thing where Space Creators did really, really well, where they kept the Anti-Mage low, and a couple of other teams as well, they ran a Darkseer versus an Anti-Mage, and normally they're going, oh, the Iron Shell's gonna really hit hard to the Anti-Mage, especially if Darkseer can find any levels, you get level 3 Iron Shell, and Anti-Mage needs to pop so many consumables, it's not funny. But what you get is the Dazzle, like, that's where the offset really kicks in. And the Dazzle's able to give you that Shadow Wave, so you get your Burst Heal, and you don't have to use too many consumables to stay alive. Prepare. He's still going to go Stout Shield, 8 Tangos as well as Salve, which is completely right, but it's just meant to get him to the point where he can buy up the Ring of Health as well as have Boots. That's his goal. Wow. Well, I'm wondering if he asked where you want me to put the ward. Gotta yell over the pinging. And the observer ward will see the entire team of SCT moving forward. Snowball into Edict. And then they're in the middle of a Rocket Barrage, Urshika Fisher. Potential double iron shells. Yeah. They're already iron shelling up. They want to try and fight this. Now, this is the vision of the Radiant side. They don't see that iron shell, but they see them all now. Tasker doesn't want to be close. Just back the crap up. If Flashrak, he didn't level up Edict, he leveled up Stun. So he's looking for the control. If they come in close enough, nope. But they see the stun's already been blown. That's a 6 second opening right now. The Ice Shard's gonna isolate two of them though. The Sentry Wall's being placed down one in the middle of this damn fight, but Musica on the back lines. He hasn't leveled up Anthing just yet. But it's the blink forward by the Queen of Pain. Really try and chase up that kill of the Lashrak, but he's gonna get double stunned because of it. The Iron Shells are still doing their work, but Toy's so low, Lashrak gets the first blood after being the thing that was on the iDeaL menu. He gets the first blood, they won't be able to get the bottom rune.
Yes.
He's making a run for the top rune, but because he gets first blood, he's gonna ferry himself out of south. Get the top rune as well, and then look into getting that bottle still at a very quick rate. Earthshaker, just looking at the fissure. But they've pushed, okay, so Noki's in the mid because the Queen of Pain was the one that died. So her bottle timing is gonna be delayed now. Because she didn't get the 100-100 rune. So that's why it's delayed, not because she lost money, because she wouldn't have. She spent all of her money before that fight. But it means that Yellow's already got advantage here in the lane. And he did take up that Lashrak, so he's all good there. 2D did go shards also at the start, so he doesn't have Snowball to get himself away. But he's kind of okay with that for the moment. They might want to get a TP scroll on the Dazzle in case he's got to jump in to give that little bit of a burst heal. That was the survivability as well. Okay, maybe I should have kept my eyes up there as Urshika rotated in. So goodbye, Tusker. The kill count's now leveled up. I kind of want to watch this battle, because for me, this is going to be the more critical lane to see the results of. To see what happens with the Darkseer. How many levels can he get? Because the Iron Shell burn damage into Musica, he's already popped this out because of the early fight. So he doesn't have those consumables in the lane anymore. So he's only got five Tango Charges. I say only 5 Tango Charges. Up against a level 3 Iron Shell, that's not really a lot. And for now, with a double stack, this Iron Shell is only level 1. So it's actually helping ST team more than anything to farm this up. If they can get a level 2 Sand King, he can actually just finish the job. And Darkseer, okay, well, he's going to throw a second one in there. So the experience will be shared, but the gold's actually going to come the way here of the Darkseer. SK's trying to keep the distance. And Numero's doing the best he possibly can. Actually managed to steal the runes. It's a double damage rune in the Darkseer. He does not want to have a bar of that. At this point, Dazzle should just walk away. Let SK finish this, get his level 2. They've still got the issue that the camp on the side, this is the one they actually really want to be stacking up. Because primarily that's the one SK wants to farm. It's close enough to the pull point where he can still protect the bottom lane. Without having to go too far away to find his farm. Yeah, he's pinging this out. What he should be dropping is like a sentry ward around here. That should be in range. And yeah, he does that exactly. He's not up on tie. He'll walk around the corner. Oh, there she is. And yeah. Easy, easy. So he'll have the 3 minute camp to farm up. Good CS for Musica so far, 14-4. Top lane's looking really good as well for the Gyro, 12-4. Queen of Pain's looking fantastic in the mid with a 13-5 up against the 8-2 of the Lashrak. This is normally not the way you'd expect this lane to go, but Toya's managed to get his bottle 3 minutes in. Looks like Lashrak's harassment hasn't done enough work yet. And the support's looking for Dire side. Level 2.5, not too shabby. And the Urshaker also up to level 2.5. And he'll look for a rotation to mid lane fairly soon. The Dire Observer Ward lets him know that no one else is behind him. And a Sentry Ward in the mid shows that there's no ward, at least sitting close on the mid lane. And Noki, yeah, okay, he just reveals himself the old-fashioned way, walks in range of the Lashrak's vision. So 2's managed to find 3.5 levels, 4.5 in for the Darkseer. And Sol Ring can be bought when he goes to the side shop. He's coming over. He's like, yeah, Yep. He's not stacking, he's not farming, he wanted to leech a little bit here, or at least contest the SK. But there was no sandstorm visible. And because he's moved off the lane now, Music is having a little bit of an easier time. Music already managed to pick up that Ring of Health and the Stout Shield which he had from the start. And with the Quelling Blade, you know it's all about the farm. He's also going to be careful on this top lane. This observer was in one of the best positions, because what it's capable of doing is actually seeing this far down. So even if you do have the Tusker, I think he's safe by walking in this direction. The glimpse can just drag him straight back to the spot, and that means Jara can just run straight down also, or go this direction and cut him off as he tries to run out a second time. So it's actually really smart. What level Shadow Strike is that? That's a level 2. He's in trouble. He's got a bottle charge in between him. Yep. And then the haste rune allows him to run all the way back to base. So Queen of Pain actually forcing the first killing Lattrak. Got first blood. They force him off the lane. He doesn't get back in there in time for the last hits there. Actually missed him because he also tried to fake out the stun. Darkseer is back to try and contest as well. That's trying to do his stack at the moment. He does not want to have Darkseer walk over here. It's not just about the money, it's about having these higher levels. Real trouble for the Lattrak. Turns on the Pulse Nova, but he knew he was dead the second that fissure connected.
I'm a pain.
iDeaL looking really good at the start of this game. Especially that Queen of Pain. Like, yeah, you had your death. It was the first one. You gave first blood to a Lattrak. Whoopity-doo-da. It happens. But in the meantime, the Queen of Pain's found a kill. The Gyro's found a kill. And they've both been on course, not on supports. This all changes around a little bit when you get to have these Blink Daggers arrive. So when Death gets a Blink Dagger, which he's rushing directly towards. Well done, Noki. He just stick around. Get level 4. He's not going to stop Death from getting the experience. Yeah, he's pinging out. Death's actually pinging out, saying, like, I'm not getting my experience I'm supposed to get. Someone else is here. And Noki's got to be careful because he's in a position where he can get fairly well trapped. Numo's on the way. SK, well, there goes your Fissure. Try to steal one of the last hits. And the Dazzle. He doesn't actually have Poison Touch, so he can't slow down the Earthshaker. And ES can just run for the Regeneration Rune if he wants it. They'd probably like to give it over towards the Darkseer, however, give him more mana. He's got Sol Ring and regen anyway, so he's got enough for all the Iron Shells he wants. Man, Vayla's really trying to get aggressive with that Split Earth. But it's so telegraphed. Like, if the Queen of Pain gets caught out by that, he's not looking at the Lattrak. That's the only way that really happens. Right, so we're 7 minutes in. 1,700 gold now on that SK. Managed to move himself up into the 5th net worth. So he's actually higher than that of the Darkseer. But that also means he's ahead of the Tusker. He's just doing it real rough on that top lane. But when the Animage is ready to move into the jungle, then you're capable of just moving the Tusker down. He can find his levels. Work his way into that classic hand of Midas that 2D likes to build into. Now it's also iDeaL's time to give their support some levels. So the Queen of Pain's been forced out of the middle lane. That's the Earthshaker competing for that 8-minute rune. He knows with the Fissure, 2D could just actually snowball this one. The Shards and Snowball can block him in with a Sigil as well. This won't be the easiest escape in the world for Noki, but he's got support coming in from the Gyro. Goes for the call down. The first rocket will connect. It's the Sonic Wave actually going on the Lattrak. The Shallowgrave TP out. There's no back. There's no more damage, but he can kill off the Dazzle at least, so he gets the consolation prize, the box of chocolates, or the board game of Wheel of Fortune, so you can replay your loss time and time again. But it's so important they kept that Lesh alive. He cannot afford to die anymore. Like, Music is getting stronger. He's at a point now where, is he actually building a Vlad's?
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
He should buy a... Yeah, he's... No, it's just the extra regen, having that Ring of Regen. But he can buy, like, that can go in later into the Vlad. So it gets the Battle Fury and then goes into Vladimir's Offering. It's good aura for the team fight. But more importantly, it means when he comes to join the fights, he's always going to have full life. Because he's got that ability just to life leech whenever he's farming up inside the jungle. So there's that blink dagger. 9 minutes for death. Well, they may have limited his ability to get that that quick level 7. Actually, even then, he's got that anyway. He actually bypasses the Barrier Strike to go in to the Epicenter instead. It's kind of interesting, because if you're going to do that, then you're looking to kill off someone like a Gyrocopter. Or to catch out the Darkseer after he's already used Surge. Because the Queen of Pain will just blink away from you. The Disruptor will just glimpse your way. The Earthshake will probably just stun you and walk away. So it's an interesting choice. Or you could just keep farming up to the next level. There's the Blink now arriving. And Toy's moving down for a haste rune. Even less time to control. And iDeaL are really grouping up. Now the TPs want to be scouted out. They smoke themselves up. And then run underneath the Radiant Observer Ward. But they're realizing it. Like there's a couple of heroes missing on the map. And they're worried about it. So Musica sees one, wants to blink a little bit further back. The glimpse is going to drag him back into the ulti and the call dance. They doubly commit to this. Musica, the Shallow Grave's going to last long enough so he can blink himself away. And now the Lashrak with the Pulse over and support coming in from Tootie. They're able to find that kill over on the Gyro with more lightning damage. Follow! He's so low! The Pulse over around the tree line! He's actually ditching so much damage, which will allow Tootie to get a follow-up, especially when you get a Burrow Strike into an Epicenter. Not to mention the Mana Void from AM. He got the kill on the Queen of Pain. Big money coming the way of AM. You lose your Lashrak. He lost 5 gold for what he did. He lost 5 gold. And they gained so much more back. Put themselves on top of the kill board for SCT. They keep Musica alive. And now they also really move forward the speed of that Battle Fury. If he can get the last hit. There we go. Now he's got enough for the broadsword. Yeah, the broadsword. But he's going to buy the Perseverance first. Okay, that's fair enough. I was going to say, then he's only going to be 800 gold away from having the rest of his Battle Fury. But that works as well. So Tuskar not going for Blink. He's going for more survivability with his team by picking up the mech. SK potentially could have gone into that. Just stack and farm up the jungle a little bit more. But decided against it. And so it looks like he's just going to go for killer build. He could still buy something like the pipe. Like, he stopped the effectiveness of the Earthshaker. He doesn't have a Blink Dagger yet. So the Echo Slam's never really going to be that big. But if you have a pipe earlier on, maybe it won't be as effective. Even like the magical cooldown. Radiant's bottom tower. There's a lot of damage to block. That's if he wants to go like proper support build. The Tuskar's gonna have to complete this into something like Greaves. He needs as much mana as he can possibly get. So get a bit of a split push right now. Double damage room from Lashrak. Being slowed down a little bit by the fortification and also the fact he didn't put a single point up into Edict. It's a 4-0-4-1 build for this Lash. I'm interested to see if he does put the point up in Edict or if he even values the stat points. It says survivability is the key. He does pick up a Vip Booster already. So that's not as much of a problem. Couple attacks to beat into the tower. And they also do a defensive weave. So if iDeaL want to fight, that's going to be fighting into heavy armor. Which again makes this Gyrocopter a lot less useful. Because what are you really expecting from the Gyrocopter? When he's got no damage healing item, he's going to build into drums. But you expend your level 3 flat cannon into a team which has like plus 10, 15 armor. It's not really the iDeaL situation for a Gyro to inflict damage. Which means you rely more on the Sonic Wave for the Queen of Pain. Currently is not here. You might want to TP back in a moment. She's actually adding pressure, but SCT brought everyone up, but they actually bring him back. The TP's coming in from the Queen of Pain. SCT have to get out of here. They don't have their Tuskar, but then again, Epicenter committal. They jump up the Barrier Strike. They go on the Gyrocopter. They're probably not expecting all of iDeaL here. They do find the pickoff. Well, it's a one-for-one trade-off, the SK for the gyro. Gyro spent his money, so we did get the drums in time. But is this how we look at it? Is this now just a space creator? Like, it created a little bit of space for the Tusker, so he's able to farm up most of his mech now because they're so far away from the bottom lane, iDeaL, that they've got that space. And the enemy just moves from camp to camp now. He's got his Battle Fury done. Got to keep our eyes also on his build. If Vlad's and Treads is the way he's looking to go here, being involved in a couple more earlier fights, or does he think something like a BKB is going to be more worthwhile? Because then there's only one real thing that will affect him. Actually, two. The slow from the cooldown, and the Sonic Wave. Radiance middle tower, the Sonic Wave damage, attack. Because it's pure. So that'll be the upside about going BKB. Queen of Pain, a blink away, and the Glimpse going to actually drag back that track a little bit further. He's going for a Bloodstone build. Looks like it's a 4-star build for the SK, but that makes sense. It's a combat build. And there's the ping coming on the animage saying, yo, guys, this guy's got a Battle Fury. It's like, yup. He's going to farm up this camp, blink down, farm the next one, and that's going to be his full treads done as well. All about that attack speed, a little bit more life switch, switch up, which he can do. Musica, they have to stop him. iDeaL need to do something about this. This BKB from the Queen of Pain, it's gonna let her fight to an extent during the engagements, but the issue you've got is the Tusker is still probably gonna punch you halfway through this. And is she really gonna give that much damage during the fights? A couple of screams off here and there. I can definitely understand her desire not to get chain stunned, but if she does get blink burrow striked and then punched, split earthed, and when there's that many people on top, you're probably going to get shadow waved, heal bombed as well. Toy's going to die before the fight even begins. And you saw SCT then, like, they blink burrow striked up, saw the disruptor, but they went with the original plan. But they only saw the disruptor once the blink came in. They went for the original plan, it's kill the gyrocopter. He must die. If they didn't commit everything they've got then, he would have actually survived. That they rely on Shallow Grave to extend these engagements. So it's a fun little, like, mind battle about how these fights are meant to go down. Because iDeaL know how they want to do it. Like, their perfect world is they get a perfect glimpse back, one isolated hero who doesn't have an escape mechanism, or at least has it disabled, pull him back into the storm, kill him off quick, and then move forward as a team. Dire's top tower and only commit call down and Sonic Wave and Echo Slam when someone, or you get like multiple people caught in. The Echo Slam's also not far off having a Blink Dagger buff, so then Noki can be in a better position. And seeing him walk up, they also see he's just got Bottle as well as Boots. It's a very raw Earthshaker. Compared to someone like a Sand King who's already building himself into a 4-star, and Musica abandoned his own jungle. He read the movement of iDeaL and just bailed the hell out. And he is actually going to go for the Vladimir's Offering. So it's the earlier fight build and a lot easier to survive if iDeaL's going to find him. It's also a lot safer having life before the fights begin. Now, Death has every set of back off cooldown. And iDeaL are pushing in. So if SCT, the iDeaL play is, they push iDeaL back to this area. And then they kill him. Or they keep him in the river. That also works. So just make it so they have to fight in this area. The epicenter will do some serious work. The Mashy Mage just sneak the SK behind the lines, while Musica keeps the pressure up on top. And iDeaL realize now their peril. They can't keep up with the split push of the Anti-Mage. They want to try and catch him up, but they've got to commit so heavily to actually do that. Like, large amounts of smokes. But then again, you also have to ask the other question, where's the vision? Is this what this Queen of Pain, like, does she have a... Do we have any... Okay, so we have Observer Wards over on the Disruptor. But the only Observer Ward they've got is a very defensive one inside the Radiant Jungle. So they can't keep tabs on what's happening with the Anti-Mage. Well, the Animage has one that's watching movement inside the Dire Jungle as well as Top River, movement across the mid, and then the rest of the team just doing their thing. Okay. We lagged up earlier today, but it's the server connection. We're perfectly all right here. In fact, yeah, it's definitely server connection as we get back in. And iDeaL was kicked out as well. That was fun. Also have a big greetings out there to everyone who's tuning in on Inside of Dota TV. It's free to watch Inside of Dota TV if you can find the game. It's rude not to answer him. The answer really is never. The internet will always lag in Australia. It is just something which most Australians have accepted, especially when they try to connect internationally. You just deal with it. And then you've got the other problem of Australia being... It's about an 11-hour flight. Unless you live in Western Australia, then it's about an 8-hour flight to get yourself up to Southeast Asia. To get into Europe, you're looking at probably 25 hours worth of travel time. Because you've got to go into Southeast Asia, then you transfer over, and very rarely do you have a direct flight unless you're in one of the big capital cities like Sydney and Melbourne. So it's kind of crap. Speaking as a guy who took very long trips. My first time I went to Sweden, I actually had to go through Beijing. And I had a 9-hour stopover in Beijing. The entire trip took me 38 hours to get from Brisbane to Sydney to Beijing to Stockholm, and then the train ride to get me to Jönköping. That was a fun time. It wasn't
Radiant's
fun.
Top tower is under attack.
Alright, whoops, what am I doing? I double clicked, I'm like, why can't I see the Earthshaker? That doesn't make any sense. Because I don't have vision of him. I was on the wrong buttons. Alright, so this Animage CS and farm is getting completely out of control. He is just taking stacks of Ancients. He'll have a mana. He'll have his BKB. Like, BKB is the item for Musica. And he knows it. He'll get the Oak Club first, get the extra life to start with. If he goes for something like a mana style. Yeah, I'm not believing in this as much, Musica. I guess really good for team fights when you got a whole bunch of yourself, because you can burn off a lot of the mana very, very quickly, and you may make it so with a small stun duration time. They've got multiple stuns which can chain off quite nicely. They can burn off all the mana of Queen of Pain in a very short amount of time, so she wouldn't then be able to blink away. Or you set up the illusions, then Disruptor doesn't know which one to send back. Like, you can play a lot more tactically when you've got your mana style. And it's decent stats. But if he gets caught inside the Disruptor ulti, that's very problematic for him. He's going to have to rely quite heavily on the rest of his team to bail him out of trouble. And that's where my question mark pops. Oh, Echo Slam, Fissure, and ulti. Wow. Sorry, that's not the reaction I meant to have for that. Wow! That's the reaction I meant to have for that. actually, there needs to be an amendment to that. Wow! That's kind of what it is. Oh, so anticlimactic. It's like, what do we got? Ah, I'm gonna reveal my first blink dagger ever. I reveal the engagement. I commit Echo Slam. We then throw the Static Storm down. Doesn't matter if Echo Slam's cooldown is over 2 minutes. We don't care about that kind of stuff here in the world of Dota. And then he just suicides. Because they don't silence the items yet. The track. Pulse Nova. Triple kill's not possible with a Fissure block. But he just took out the Queen of Pain as well as the Disruptor. And they're even going to steal the Ancients that are remaining here while Musica pushes in the top lane. How much was lost? Then again, how much was gained? 1,600 gold into a Latrak for these two kills. He gets two Bloodstone charges back as well, which should never be underestimated. You may even think with this injection of money that they should... longest smoke ever. That he should just buy BTs. Like, that's another option they could go with. So then they really turn to split push, but he's actually going for a ghoul. Is he really thinking about Glimmer? Yup. I didn't even have to double check it. I'm just like, what else does a Shadow Amulet create? The easy answer's Shadow Blade or Glimmer Cape. I'm like, there's no third item. There's no new thing that's made. It's not a Lotus. It's not a Nocturne. It's a Glimmer Cape from the Latrak. But it gives him, it actually gives him what he wants. Like, it gives him his escape mechanism. It also gives him just a nice balanced resistance against most of the magical stuff that iDeaL is pumping out. Because he knows the BKB won't protect him from the Queen of Pain anyway. So if he gets the Glimmer Cape for now, he could build into other tanky strength items and just resist everything that iDeaL throw. Because once they throw out... like, actually, that's actually kind of hilarious when you think about it. Imagine iDeaL without abilities. There's nothing. Absolutely nothing. Death. He's got Burrow Strike. He's fine. No, Burrow Strike actually out from two. Oh, okay. Glimmer back in again, but a four star up. He can also sandstorm himself out right now if he wants to, but look at Velo. He just runs in. It's like glimmering boys. I'm a shimmering beacon of hope. For at least the Australians. For everyone else, it's a disaster for him. Queen of Pain needs to blink away. Tuskar getting himself a little bit caught in the high ground. Darkseer, the same kind of scenario. But there's more Suns and Pulse Nova work going to work here. So the rocket will connect. But it's Latrak picking up a double kill. Anime's taking out the bottom lane. Again, it's smoke and mirrors. The Latrak is a distraction. He is literally trying to make himself the brightest star in the history of Dota. Just so iDeaL a blinded. Oh, the pain of Queen. Oh, that's a searing one. Hey, that's like a proper Indian curry that burns on the way up again. Dire's top tower is under attack. TP'd in, thought he was good. Music was about to blink away. He was like, oh, I'm not even part of this one. And then he'd look at it and go, wait, the Queen of Pain was just in a fight. She came in with practically no mana. Attacks her twice. It's like, oh, got this in the bag. Smoke movement time. They're coming up to the top lane. It's a level 2 Epi, which has already been prepared. A Mech Tuskar behind him. Dazzle's left, at least. That's a 3-man smoke move through the dire jungle. The SK into the sandstorm. Again, Burrow Strike. Need to keep that stun going. Death. Burrow Strike under. He's dead, though. Then they're going to glimpse him back in again. They bottle charge and then four staff down. Not so dead. He's got Blink Dagger off cooldown in 1 second time. Into the sandstorm to buy him that time away. They need to get rid of this rocket. He's Burrow Striking as far away as possible. What level rocket is that? It's a level 1. It won't kill him. He'll actually survive through it all. They try to drag him back. And iDeaL keep committing so many resources to finding these pickoffs. And they get nothing in return. Absolutely nothing in return. Really problematic. And Velo's again gonna make this run up. He's like, I'm sure someone's gonna be up on that high ground. It's actually the Queen of Pain. Wanting to turn for the Sonic Wave. Actually started twice, stopped twice, and in comes Animage, making more of themselves. There's a good Darkseer wall here. Really problematic until Death comes in. The Echo Slam trying to buy some space, but it's a level 1 Echo. The damage is minimal. The Snowball protects, and they just dive in deeper. The cooldown has no real effect. Queen of Pain is down for the count, and GG! SCT will take the victory in 25 minutes. It is 15-7, and congratulations, courtesy of Corsair. They will take home 1,500 USD, and 500 goes to iDeaL. They still played a great game. They got the honor of representing Thailand in the grand final after semi-final victory earlier today. And I hope you all enjoyed the show. If you want to check out the details of this coverage, you can go to joinDOTA.com. We have it all listed there. Just go to the very top bar and you'll see coverage. Just go show all. You can actually look up any coverage of any tournament in the entire world of Dota 2. It's all available there. And make sure you tune in later on tonight. Mon Capitalist will be joining the studio. He'll be casting the ESL qualifiers for the Red Bull competition, which we're doing as well. They'll be over on our joinDOTA ESL channel, but you can find the links for, of course, all live streams. Would you believe it? At the website, joinDOTA.com. That's the place to go. So thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed the show, and hopefully I'll see you back on the airwaves sometime soon as well. Social networks when I get it back from them. In time. It will come! It will come. Thanks for watching. See you next time.